In this video, I want to talk about how to combine content together with you in your LightBoard scenes. And really, this is one of the most powerful tools for teaching. I know that many people over the years have built up these vast libraries of PowerPoint slides that they use to teach their courses. And when you come over to the LightBoard platform, the beauty of it is that I can now add my slides in together with me and the LightBoard, and it allows me to actually write on my slides. So instead of being in a classroom showing my slides on a screen and then using a laser pointer to point at things, I can actually be in together with my content. I can point with my finger, or I can write on the LightBoard, you know, with a marker, and I can annotate live my actual course content. And I don't need to make new content. I can use the content that I already have. That's the great beauty of what I'm about to show you. This video needs to be sort of complemented by another video, and that is, I need to also show you how to save your PowerPoint slides with the right colors and how to save them as image files. So I'll cover that in a separate video. But for this video, I'll assume you've already done that and that we're in OBS and I've got my video camera set up. I've got the image flipped around and really now I just need those slides. So what I do is I come down here to my sources and I will add a new source and I'm going to choose image slideshow. I choose image slideshow. I say create a new image slideshow. Then I have some choices here. I'll say always play even when not visible. For slide mode, I'm actually going to change that to manual, which uses something called hotkeys, and that I'll use hotkeys to advance my slides. I'll move that over so you can see me. I'll use it to go forwards or backwards manually using some hotkeys on my keyboard. You could also do it with a remote if you wanted to program a remote to do that. Now to get my slides, I kind of scroll down in the same window and under this empty box where it has looks like it has space for a list of image files, I hit the plus button to add them and I'm going to click add files. I used to do add directory because I thought I was being very clever to add all the slides in a directory, but I had problems with that because OBS would reorder my slides in a different alphabetical order than what Windows did. So better practice is to click add files, and I'm going to thank my friend Sarah for that tip. So then I find the folder, and I'm already in that folder, and this is a folder with some slides for my engineering economics class, and then I'm simply going to select all of the files. I'll use the shift key to highlight them all, and I'll click open, and then here you see them all sort of appear, and in the background you can actually see the slides appear. I hit OK, and now you can't see me because I'm behind the slides, but that's okay. I can grab this window and I can pull it over, and now you can see me, but I still can't write on my slide. Well, what I've done is I've created these image slides in PowerPoint with a black background, and then what I do is I apply something called a color key. So I select this stack of images, and then I hit something called filters, and there's something called effect filters, and I'll scroll down here to the bottom. I'll hit a plus sign to add a new filter. I will select color key, and I'll say okay, and then color key type, you see the default is green, and this comes from sort of green screen technology, but I find I'm getting a nice crisp look when I use black. So I'm going to click that color. I'm going to scroll down and say custom color. And then I'll click select color. And I'm going to select black. You can see all the values here are zero in the old RGB value system. I'll click OK and I close. And now what OBS has done, very smart program, is that it's looked through this all of my slides and has removed all the black. And now what it means is that I can come in here and now I can underline things. I can circle things. You know, if I want to, I can write right on my slide. And that's the great beauty of combining the LightBoard with OBS. But I'm not quite done yet. I still need to be able to advance my slides to move through them. And how I do that is I just take note that this is, when I added this, this OBS added this as image slideshow 5. So I just take note of that. I come up here to File, and I go to Settings, and then I select Hotkeys, and then there's all kinds of cool stuff you can do in here with hotkeys, but I'm, for now, I'm just going to find my image slideshow. I'm going to slide down here to Image Slideshow 5, and what I do is I use Control Right, and I just hold those keys after I've selected that empty space, that field in OBS, and then I hit the keys again. I'm going to do Control Left to go back. So that's, so to go to the next slide in Image Slideshow 5, I hit Control Right, and to go to the previous slide, I hit Control Left. Then I just come down here, hit Apply, OK, and now when I'm back in OBS, if I hit Control Right, that takes me to my next slide. Control Right takes me to my next slide. Control Left brings me back to the original. So that's a quick word on how we import image slideshow slides produced in PowerPoint into OBS, and how we remove the background, and also how we advance the slides using hotkeys.